हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू फाइनेंस एमसीक्यू। फ्रेंड्स, इंडियन ऑयल हैज रिलीज नोटिफिकेशन फॉर एंगेजमेंट ऑफ अप्रेंटाइज फॉर इट्स रिफाइनरी डिवीजन। सो लेट्स डिस्कस दिस इन डिटेल। फ्रेंड्स, एट कोड नंबर 108, इफ यू कैन सी, दे हैव रिलीज ट्रेड अप्रेंटिस सेक्रेटरियल असिस्टेंट वैकेंसीज एंड द क्वालिफिकेशन रिक्वायर्ड इज 3 ईयर BA, BSc एंड BCom। And at code number 109, vacancy is trade apprentice accountant vacancy and the qualification required is 3 years BCom. So friends, we will keep our focus on trade apprentice accountant vacancies only, and if any candidate who is either a BA, BSc or BCom who is interested in secretarial practice can apply for trade apprentice secretarial assistant vacancy. But for this video we will keep our focus on trade apprentice accountant vacancies and its related details. So friends, the period of training will be 12 months, so it's a 12 month apprenticeship program, and for its various locations of Indian Oil like Guwahati, Gujarat, Haldia, Mathura, Panipat, etc. The total number of vacancies are 32. So it's 32 vacancies for all different locations. So if you are interested in any of this location, so you can apply for it. And also they have mentioned the various reserved seat for all types of category, including unreserved category candidates. So you can go through them in detail notification. Now let's talk about the other terms and conditions regarding these vacancies. Now let's discuss the qualification criteria prescribed for trade apprentice accountant. Friends, the qualification is graduate with regular full-time course. So it should not be a distance learning. You have to be graduate from regular 3 years course with minimum 50% marks for unreserved category candidates and 45% for SC, ST and PWD candidates. And friends, they want only graduate in BCom as an eligible qualification. So if you are BBA or something like that and want to apply for trade apprentice accountant, then you are not eligible. You have to be only bachelor's of commerce with 3 years regular course, then only you are eligible to apply for this post. And here you can see they have mentioned candidates holding a qualification acquired through part-time or correspondence distance education are not eligible. So they have categorically rejected that. You have to be full-time. And friends, they have also mentioned if you are having higher qualifications such as BE, BTech, MBA, CA, LLB, MCA, then you are not eligible to apply. So do keep this in mind. It's only for BCom graduate candidates and not for others, higher qualified candidates. And a candidate should not have undergone apprenticeship training earlier. So if you have already did apprenticeship somewhere else, then you are not eligible. And if you are having job experience for 1 or more years, then you are also not eligible. So you should not have any experience, any job experience for more than 1 year to apply for this. And a BCom candidate will be allowed to apply for one trade or discipline, that is either he can apply for secretarial assistant or accountant. So it's up to you which one you want to apply, but you can apply for only one position and not for both. And if you apply for more than one position, then your application will be rejected. So do keep this in mind while filing up the form. Now the age limit. Friends, minimum age required is 18 years and maximum age required is 24 years as on 31st October 2021. So by this time you should be, maximum age should be 24 years. It is for general and EWS candidates, and relaxation is provided to SC, ST and OBC PWD candidates. So they have mentioned that upper age limit is relaxed up to 5 years for SC, ST category and 3 years for OBC non creamy layer candidates. So you can go through the all age relaxations and other criteria in detail in the detail notification. I will put the notification link in the description, so you can go through that in detail. And friends, you need to possess the desired qualification and you have to meet the age criteria as on 31st October 2021. So by this date you should be a graduate and also you should meet the age requirement as specified by them. And they have mentioned that upon completion of apprenticeship period, the company will be in no obligation to offer employment. So these vacancies are only for the purpose of training and your grooming, and it should not be considered as a regular employment after completion of this training. So it will be a learning experience only and not a permanent job. So do keep this in mind. And now let's talk about the selection methodology, how you will be selected. So friends, it will be based on written test of 2 hours, and in case of a tie, 2 or more marks in written test, then date of birth, senior by age, shall be the factor. So if you are senior in age and the score is tie, then the person who is senior will be selected. And they have specified the venue for the exam, so you can go through them in detail, and exact venue will be communicated in the admit card. And friends, your written test will be objective type, multiple choice questions, that is MCQ based test. It will have 4 options with 1 correct option, and a candidate need to score minimum 40% marks in written test, and the minimum qualifying marks for SCST and PWD candidates are 35%. So that is the minimum marks that you need to score to qualify, and the various documents required are also mentioned here. You can go through them in detail. Friends, you will be paid stipend as per the prescribed apprenticeship act and the related guidelines. So they have not mentioned the exact amount, so it's mentioned in the apprenticeship act that as per that act you will be paid stipend, and company will not provide any HRA or accommodation, and the leave and holiday is mentioned. General 32 days leave are allowed, that is 8 days per quarter is allowed, and casual 12 days leave is allowed. Then how to apply and all these things are mentioned, you can go through them. They have mentioned if you have any queries or clarification required, so unit wise they have provided contact number and email address. So if you are applying for say Guwahati Refinery Division, then you can contact the respective numbers and email address to get the clarification of your query. And now let's talk about the important dates. So friends, your online applications are already started from 22nd October 2021, and the last date for submission of application is 12th November 2021, and your tentative date for downloading the admit card is 16th November to 20th November. And your written test will be on 21st November 2021. So it's really a good thing that within 1 month they are conducting the written test, and your written test result will be on 4th December 2021. And your document verification will be from 13th December to 20th December 2021. So by the end of the year, it will be clear that who is selected and who is not selected. So friends, all those BCom graduate candidates who wants to get a learning experience in working in a PSU organization should definitely apply for this post, since it's very good opportunity to work with a reputed PSU organization. And if you find this information useful, then do share with the other people also whom you find that it will be beneficial. So all the best, and thank you so much for watching this video till the end.